John! John!
What is it, old man?
It's Jack. The kid. The kid. Well, I just saw him out in the valley. Seems your tales of hunting got the better of him. He said he was going up to the pass, track down that grizzly that's been seen up there.
Kid can't hunt a grizzly. Thing will eat him alive.
I know. I tried to stop him.
But you're worthless as a lawyer at a lynch. Damn you, old man. This is my son. Anything happens to him, you wish it was you that bear attacked. Let's go. Go on. Find Jack, boy. Come. Come on. Where's Jack? Slow down. Come on, Rufus. What you got, boy? Can you smell something? Let's go. Where's Jack? Where is he? Come on. Come on, boy. Where is he? Find Jack, Rufus! Come on, easy up there. You can find him, boy. Jack! Can you hear me, Jack? Jack! Answer me! Let's go!
On your own. You're just a boy.
No, I'm not. I can skin an elk, rake horses.
Come on, let's get you home. Now hold tight. Come on. Are you all right?
Yeah, I think so.
You're lucky to be alive, you stupid boy. What'd I tell you about going off by yourself?
I go off by myself plenty. You just don't know about it. You're never around.
So this is my fault? You disobeyed me.
I was trying to prove myself.
Prove what? By getting yourself killed?
You're always telling me I read too many books, that I'm not a real man.
I never said that.
I just thought if I could do something you'd like, maybe you wouldn't go away again.
Son, I ain't going anywhere. And believe me, neither are you for a real long time. your mother gonna say?
I'm sorry, Paul. Please don't be angry.
I ain't angry. Disappointed. Don't you ever run off on your own like that again.
All right, all right. I told you I was sorry.
What would have happened if I hadn't come along?
I don't know. I'd probably be dead.
You'd be a pile of bones right now.
What would you care? I'm just a nuisance to you anyway.
That ain't true, Jack. I'd do anything for you. You know that.
I guess there's only room for one hero in this family.
Trust me, son. I ain't no hero. I'm just glad you're safe. Going after a grizzly? What were you thinking? You've only been hunting twice.
I'm not a little kid anymore. What were you doing at my age?
Bad things. Things nobody should do. But your ma and me, we didn't have what you have.
Yeah, yeah, I know. I should be grateful.
I'm not asking you to be grateful. I'm asking you to do what I say before you get yourself killed.
It's always one set of rules for you and another set for everybody else. You think I don't know what you did back in the old days? I'm not stupid.
You could have fooled me.
You think I didn't sit up and listen to Dutch and Bill telling all those stories? I'm sorry I made you worry, Paul.
Don't be too eager to grow up, son. Ain't as much fun as it looks. When you're ready to hunt bears, I'll take you. Hey, Jack.
Hey, Paul.
Need a hand with that?
No, sir, I got it.
Looks like you have. You know, you're real good with them tools.
Thank you, Paul.
You'll make this land real nice one day. Me and your mother will do our part. By the time your turn comes, hell, this could be the nicest farm in the county.
Maybe, Paul.
Just gotta learn to shoot straight or you'll get yourself eaten by some animal.
Very funny, Paul.
Thank you, son. Soon it'll be quail season. We should have some fun then.
Is there anything you don't like shooting, Paul?
Well, I ain't met the thing yet, but as soon as I do, I'll let you know. You can even put it in one of them books you read.
Yeah, maybe I'll do that. Today, John Marston stops shooting.
Now, I ain't no literary man, but I don't think that'll sell. People like shooting in them things.
I think you may be right there, Paul.
So, you ever hear talk about them machines that can make a man fly?
Well, sure, Paul. Everybody knows about that. You know they're gonna be bringing one of those machines around the country next year for a demonstration? One of them machines can turn men into angels.
One of them machines can turn men into angels.
Look at that.
Jack, go into the house, lock all the doors. Whatever happens, don't come outside. You hear me? Whatever happens.
Okay.
Come here, son. Whatever happens, keep the doors locked and your mother inside. Promise me, son. Promise me.
Who is it, Paul?
It's just some old friends. Me and Uncle take care of it. And you go inside and you keep the doors and the windows locked.
I hear you.
Then run!
Yeah, run, boy!
Well, old man, looks like things is about to get settled once and for all.
So it seems.
For the love of God!
There's still time for you to run, old...
Jesus! Get off our way! Run away! Maybe I won't kill you! y'all down.
You best get that gun ready, old man.
Check on your family, boy. Get inside. I'll keep watch out here. Get in there. There'll be more coming.
What are we gonna do now?
What's wrong? What's happened?
Stay inside, you hear? Like I said. There'll be more coming.
Paul, what do they want?
I don't know, son. Whatever it is, it ends here.
Oh, look how many there are. They're gonna kill us, aren't they?
No, I ain't gonna let that happen.
Government!
I thought we were friends! Don't waste time aiming, just shoot! Paul, hit something!
Are you all right?
Damn it! I've been hit!
You won't take us away again! No! Not again!
That's it! Give him out, son!
Gonna make it off this porch anyhow. You take Jack and Abby. Take them and don't worry about me. Let's get them out of here.
No! Uncle, please! Oh my God! They killed him!
Come on, son! Ain't nothing we can do for him now! We're leaving the farm. I'll watch from the silo. You two go to the barn. Get the horses ready.
John!
I'll meet you there. did what you wanted! Keep your heads down! Till I say so! Keep your eyes open! Let's head for the barn! All right, you're covered! Now go! Go! Now! Quick! Run for it! That's too close for my liking! All right, you're covered! Now go! Go! Listen, Jack, Gnarlin, get on this horse. Get out of here. Go find a place to hide.
You're coming with us, Paul.
I'll catch up. You keep riding and don't look back. And don't be worrying about me, you hear? Now get going.
You stay out of trouble, John.
Ain't no trouble, Abigail. Ain't no trouble. I love you.
I love you.
Now go! Get!
Jack, we have to go back for Pa.
Let's go!
Bury me not on the lone prairie where the coyotes wail and the wind blows free. And when I die, don't bury me 'neath the western sky.
Hello there, sir. You look like a man who can do an honest day's work for an honest day's pay.
Well, then looks can be deceiving, pal.
Perfect. As honesty is, in my business, the worst policy. I work for our well-respected governor, Nate Johns.
Yeah, it makes sense.
Now, there is a certain individual spreading nasty rumors about Mr. Johns. I'd like you to put a stop to this vile gossip and malingering.
I suppose I could handle that for the right price.
Now, This individual has had the misfortune to be photographed enjoying some rather inappropriate company. Been seen with a local whore. Take these photographs to him. After you take care of business, return to me and I'll pay up the reward for your services. You're doing great things for your state, dear friend. You should be proud.
Bye-bye.
Hurry along, then.
Learn some etiquette. Step to it.
Government agent, stop bank hide. Get your paper.
Howdy. Sorry, sir.
Hello, young man.
Hello, sir. You work with the government? You one of them agents?
Sure, son. Why you ask?
Did you work with a man named Edgar Ross? I have something for him.
Edgar Ross? No, but well knew of him. A fine man if you want the results. Won himself a chest full of medals. I think he went and retired about a year ago. Last I heard, him and his wife moved out to a cabin on Lake Don Julio. Lucky guy, getting to take it easy. He's fighting crime in this dump, that's for sure.
Well, thank you for the information, mister.
Here to keep you safe. Still here?
Somebody just stole my horse. Pony up and stop him.
Join me?
Howdy.
Hey, good to see you.
I'm gonna get some rest. Excuse me, ma'am.
Hello, young man.
Hi.
What are you doing out here? Are you out visiting the lake with your family?
No, ma'am. I was looking to deliver a letter to Edgar Ross.
Oh, that husband of mine. That bureau just won't get its talons out of him, even though he's retired. Edgar gave them some of the best years of his life. They ought to let him retire in peace. They'll not rest till they've killed him with worry, and he's such a sensitive man. I'm sorry, I shouldn't get so angry. I don't suppose any of this is your fault. There's no need to worry about him nowadays.
Well, where is he?
He and his brother Philip went hunting on the south side of the San Luis River. Be careful crossing over. They were saying it was dangerous.
I sure will, ma'am. And don't worry about a thing. I'm sure your husband will be just fine.
You should be able to catch him if you leave now.
Come on, slow down. Hey there, mister. How's the hunting?
Oh, pretty good, son. Got me a few rabbits, coyote, elk. Still looking for some trophies for the parlor.
I've got a letter here for Edgar Ross. You know him? I heard he was down in these parts with his wife.
Of course I know him. He's my brother. Gone down river, duck hunt. Must be a pretty important letter that'll come all this way.
Yes, sir. Real important. I'll be on my way home as soon as I deliver this message.
You best be off then. Just don't get on his bad side. He's got a filthy temper.
Excuse me. You Edgar Ross?
Do I know you?
Forgive me for startling you, sir. I have a message for you. My name is Jack Marston. You knew my father.
I see. I remember your father.
I've come for you, Ross.
And you, boy, have sure as shit found.
You killed my father.
Your father killed himself with the life he lived.
You killed him. I saw you.
You keep saying that.
You sent him to do your dirty work. Then you shot him like a dog.
And I'll shoot you like one too, you little piece of trash. Now get out of here before I kill you as well.
I ain't going nowhere, old man.